Alright, so magandang araw sa ating lahat na nandito na tayo sa fourth grading or fourth quarter period ng ating lesson 40 grade 9 science. And then, proceed na tayo, hindi naman tayo nagmamadali kaya atin na simulan. Okay, so nandito tayo sa first topic natin, which is yung projectile motion. Maraming sakot ng mga lessons natin yung fourth grading, pero it focuses all about topics, no? Or deeper topics or deeper concepts pagdating sa physics, no? May halong computation siya. And then, simulan na natin. If you have an experience in playing shadow, they use two sticks in which one of the sticks are longer than the other, with a small hole about 2 inch long or 2 inches long on the ground, and place the small stick horizontally across it. We position the long stick in the middle of the short one and hit it strongly in the direction of their opponents. So, sa pamagitan ng paglalaro natin ng shatong, may apply natin dito yung una, yung trajectory. So, in this game, once the shorter stick is hit, it flies in the air following a curved path. No, yung curved path na yun, ay tinutukoy natin siya as trajectory. Trajectory is the path traveled by a projectile. In terms of projectile, it is an object thrown horizontally, which is acted upon by the force of gravity. Kung ano yung nakikita niyong actual projectile motion na nakamark na kulay blue, yun po yung projectile motion or yung projectile. Projectile motion refers to the motion of an object that is thrown or projected into the air at an angle. So marami tayong iba't-ibang klase ng projectile. May mga vertical and horizontal projectiles tayo. Horizontal and vertical dimension with an application na rin ng projectile. Malalaman natin siya later on. No? And then, the motion of a projectile is determined only by the object's initial velocity and gravity. Okay, may halong computation ba ito? Obviously po, meron. Mamaya makakita natin. So, a projectile, once projected, continues in motion by its own inertia and is influenced only by the downward force of gravity. And then, let us apply this kind of example. Place two identical coins at the edge of the tabletop. Push one of the coins horizontally while simultaneously drop the other coin vertically. So what did you observe? So according to our observation, the coin which is dropped followed by a vertically straight path, while the coin which is pushed horizontally traveled a curved path. So, base sa nakita natin dito, may application tayo dito na tinatawag natin na free fall. So yung free fall, ito yung vertical motion of the coin drop dun pababa. Then, free fall is a motion of any object that is acted upon only by the force of gravity. In all points of the motion, the coin has a constant acceleration equivalent of the acceleration due to the gravity. So, yung acceleration due to gravity, alam naman na, tingin ko alam nyo na to nung kayo i-grade 8 pa lamang. But, ang acceleration due to the gravity, meron tayong, ano ba tawag dito? Constant value. No? Ang unit niya is G. And then, yung constant value niya is 9.8 meter per second squared. So, thus, the vertical component of the motion of a projectile is described as uniformly accelerated motion. When the coin is at rest on the table, it has an initial vertical speed of 0. However, it gains speed as it moves down vertically. Each second of its fall is equivalent to a gain of 9.8 meter per second. So, an object projected horizontally will reach to the ground in the same time as an object dropped vertically. No matter how large the horizontal velocity is, the downward pull of gravity is always the same. So, yun yung conclusion niya. So, the cannon pull falls the same amount of distance as it did when it was merely dropped from rest. Okay. So, nandito na tayo sa uniform motion. So, on the other hand, the motion of the coin pushed horizontally is described as uniform motion. In this motion, constant horizontal velocity is observed. Since the velocity is constant, then acceleration along the horizontal component is zero. This means that there is no horizontal component of force acted on the coin. Only gravity then acted on it. So, In terms of horizontal dimension, if a body maintains a constant change in its velocity in a given time interval along the straight line, then the body is said to have a uniform acceleration. Consider an airplane on a runway preparing for takeoff. Positions taken at equal time interval are indicated in the figure below, tulad ng nakita ninyo. So, the change in an airplane's position for each time interval is increasing, as shown in this figure, thus it is moving faster and faster. This means that the plane is accelerating. No? So, in computing the slope, you will divide distance by time, which is actually the speed of an object. You will now relate these quantities in the derivation of formula to solve problems relating to uniformly accelerated motion. No? So, natutunan nyo naman yung displacement, velocities, and acceleration na tayo yung grade 7 and grade 8 palabang. So, ito'y parang nire-recall ko lang kayo ng content. So, now you will use those basic equations to derive formula used in uniformly accelerated motion. So, lahat na natutunan natin noon, I hope na natatandaan nyo pa. No? So, pwede nyo naman balikan yung mga videos nyo para mas maalala nyo pa. Within nung kayo ay grade 7 and grade 8. So, check nyo na lang sa playlist. Nandun lang siya para mas madali siya makita. Then, so, ayan po yung mga formulas na kailangan natin gamitin, no? So, yung V stands for velocity. Yung VF stands for final velocity. Yung VI stands for the initial velocity. Then, VAVE, which means average velocity. Yung D, displacement. D stands for the time, and A stands for the acceleration. So, from equation A, ayan, velocity, or in some other textbook, kinoconsider ito na speed, or velocity na gamitin natin. Velocity is equals to distance over time. Pero kapag dinisect natin yung mga, ano na yan, yung mga formulas na ito, yung displacement, kung i-breakdown natin siya, para makuha natin yung displacement, kailangan alamin natin yung kanyang final velocity, and then isusubtract natin siya sa initial velocity, no? So, yung time na yan, na-replace siya into 2. And then, suddenly, meron tayong VAVE, which means yung kanyang average velocity. And then hanggang sa may apply natin yung yung application ng formula ng acceleration, no? So yung acceleration is equals to final velocity subtracted to initial velocity over time, no? Then alam natin na medyo magkakaiba sila. So as you observe dito sa ano na yan, sa mga formulas or yung equation na nandito, using this kind of following equations on velocity, average velocity, and acceleration, you can derive other kind of equation. No? Then, it's like this. To find out how displacement changes within time when an object is uniformly accelerated, we must rearrange equation A to arrive at D is equals to V and D. Since the velocity of the object changes when it is uniformly accelerating, we use the average velocity to determine displacement. So you will substituting V by VAV, or yung average velocity in equation B, you will get from dito, nag-transform siya into dito. No? So, katulad din dito, kung hindi ganun masyadong nag-specific yung pagpapakita ng equation, mas nakita natin yung transformation nila, di ba? Mas nakita natin yung derivation ng equation kumpara doon. And then, we must rearrange equation C to arrive at VF is equals to, or yung final velocity is equals to initial velocity. Then, ipag-a-add natin sila sa acceleration multiply by D time. No? So, ibig sabihin yung add na yan, kasama siya sa formula na yan, ayan, yung nakikita ninyo. Ayan, para mas masundan nyo siya. And substituting the final velocity in equation D. So, you will get from dito sa equation C, nag-transfer na siya dito sa equation D. Bagong equation na po siya. So, this displacement is equals to, yun nga, naka-bracket yata. No? So, initial velocity plus acceleration multiplied by time. Then, ipagpa-plus natin sila sa initial velocity ulit. No? And then, multiply natin ulit siya sa time. And then, divide natin siya sa 2. So, ganun yung mangyayari. yan. So combining VI, you will arrive at D is equals to 2VI plus 80 multiplied by T divided by 2. So we must distribute T, will give you, ayan na siya, 2VIT plus 80 squared divided by 2. So, isi-simplify na natin siya at ganito na yung lumabas. So, ito na po yung equation niya. So, this shows that the displacement of the body is directly proportional to the square of time. This confirms that for equal interval of time, displacement increases quadratically. And then, to find out how velocity depends, no, sa ating displacement, substitute velocity and time from equation B and C to T is equals to VT. And you will find that ito na yung magiging outcome niya. So, recall from your algebra class, no? Sana naiintindihan po yung algebra, no? But kapag naiintindihan natin yung mga algebra concepts, no? Or basic algebra concepts, just like yung A plus B multiplied by A minus B is equals to A2 minus B2. Ayan. So ito na po yung lumabas. And then we will need to simplify that. So, makukuha natin is yung 2AD is equals to VF2 minus VI2. So, rearrange natin. At ito na yung lumabas. Kumbaga, nilipat natin yung final velocity squared dito sa kabila. And then, nag-transform sila. At ganito na yung naging derivation ng equation na ito. So, para ma-apply natin yung mga derived equations na ito. So, we must apply this by study and solving this kind of particular problems. So, nandito na tayo sa sample problems in horizontal dimension. So, okay. So, sample problem number 1. An airplane accelerates from rest on a runway at 5.50 meter per second squared for 20.25 seconds until it finally takes off the ground. So, what is the distance covered before takeoff? So, yung given natin is ayan. So, yung acceleration is 5.50 meter per second squared, and then yung time natin is 20.25 second. Then, suddenly, yung mismong takeoff niya, kapag sinabi kasi nating takeoff, yung initial na bilis niya para bumaba siya sa particular na ground o yung mismong tatapakan niya. So, kumbaga sa takeoff, dito sa situation na ito, tinutukoy natin yung takes off the ground as an initial velocity kasi wala pa siya dun sa baba eh, at wala pa yung final velocity niya kasi nandun pa lang siya sa air. Wala naman siya na-mention, at ang gagamitin natin value ng initial velocity is 0 meter per second. Then yung required is yung distance kasi yun ang tinatanong. Ayan. Then yung equation is D is equals to initial velocity multiplied by time is equal to is plus acceleration multiply by time squared, no, divided by 2. So, solution, replace natin yung mga variables na given dito. So, i-multiply yung mga dapat i-multiply by itself, just like yung value ng time na 20.25 second. And then, ipag-multiply na natin itong part na ito. So, ayun na po. So, 0 meter per second squared plus 5.50 meter per second squared multiplied by 410.0625 second squared. I-divide natin siya sa 2. So, i-cancel out natin yung mga dapat na i-cancel out. So, ayun na yung naging value niya. So, 2,255.34375 meter na naging ano niya, value niya. Since, kinancel out natin yung same unit. And then, the right answer for that is is ayan. So, yung ating final answer is 1, round off natin, no? So, from 1,127.671875, round off natin siya into 1,128 as their answer. So, next one. From rest, a jeepney accelerates uniformly over a time of 3.25 seconds and covers a distance of 15 meters. So, acceleration naman yung hanapin natin, o yung acceleration ng jeepney. So, yung given, yung distance natin is 15 meters, yung time is 3.25 seconds, and then yung initial velocity niya is 0 meter per second since wala naman siya na-mention doon. So, yung record is yung acceleration. And yung equation natin na D is equals to initial velocity multiplied by time plus acceleration multiplied by time squared divided by 2. So yung solution, i-replace natin lahat ng mga units na available or yung mga variables na available to base dun sa ating given, i-multiply yung mga dapat na i-multiply at i-multiply by itself ang dapat na i-multiply by itself. So ayan, so 15 meters since may value tayo ng d, may gagawin tayo dyan. So 10.5625 second squared divided by. So ayan, base sa nakita natin, dinivide na natin yung 10.5625, no, into divided by 2. So ayan na yung naging outcome niya. And then ang mangyayari dito is magkakaroon, itatranspose natin sila, and then i-divide natin yung acceleration, ililipat natin sa kabila, and then yung 15 meter is ililipat natin dito sa kabila din. So ang mangyayari, magkakaroon ng division dito na 15 meter divided by 5.28125 second squared. So ang ating final answer is 2.8 meter per second squared, no, kung susubukan natin itong kalkulahin, no. So divide lang naman natin yung 15 dun sa 5.28125. So ayun na po siya, or sabihin natin kung gusto niyo ng 2 decimal places, 2.84 maging answer niyo. So nandito na tayo ulit, no. So lumipat lang tayo sa kabilang dimension. Kung kanina nasa horizontal dimension tayo, nandito na tayo sa vertical dimension. So you learned in grade 8 that the pull of gravity acts on all objects. So on Earth, when you throw something up, it will go down. It will go down, no. So things thrown upward always falls at a constant acceleration na may magnitude na 9.8 meter per second squared. So this means that the velocity of an object in free fall changes by 9.8 meter per second every, yun nga, 9.8 meter per second of fall, no. So consider a stone dropped from a cliff as shown in this figure. For equal time interval, the distance traveled increases quadratically. So another example of free fall is a body thrown upward. Consider in this figure on the right where a ball is thrown upward. As the ball goes up, it decelerates with a magnitude of 9.8 meter per second squared until it stops momentarily and changes direction. That means it reaches its maximum height before it starts to fall. Using this equation, you will also find that when the ball falls back to the point where it was thrown, its speed will be equal to the speed at which it was thrown. Note that the magnitudes of the two velocities are equal, but they have opposite directions. Velocity is upward when it was thrown, but downward when it's returned. So now we will go forward to the next part of the lesson, in which giving another sample problems, most of the formula equations na magagamitin natin is nagamit na natin nung una, pero i-rearrange na natin at i-base sa nakakita natin sa word problem or at pati namin sa solution. So nandito na tayo sa sample problem sa vertical dimension. So Hayate, ayun, meron na lumabas. So Hayate is playing with a ball on top of a building, but the ball fell and hit the ground after 2.6 seconds. So what is the final velocity of the ball just before it hits the ground, and how high is the building? May tutunan. Anuin natin. Ito kaya. So meron tayong given na acceleration due to gravity na negative 9.8 meter per second squared. No? Kasi nasa vertical dimension tayo, plus meron mga factors na naka-affect dito sa value ng acceleration due to gravity, specifically sa free fall, kaya naapektuhan yung value niya into a negative value. So yung time natin is 2.6 second, and then yung assumed initial velocity natin is 0 meter per second. So yung required is yung final required value na hinanap natin is final velocity and then yung height. So ang equation na gagamitin natin is final velocity is equals to initial velocity plus acceleration due to gravity multiplied by time. So at saka yung d is equals to vit plus at squared divided by 2. So yung solution, ito muna gagamitin natin sa final velocity. So i-replace ang mga dapat na i-replace na given variables. So i-multiply ang dapat na i-multiply. And then yung ating final velocity is negative 25.48 meter per second. So sa isa naman, sa height naman, gagamitin natin na formula is yung sa distance. Pero paano mangyayari yun? Tandaan natin na ang height ay equivalent na siya ng negative value ng distance from a distance. So, i-replace ang mga dapat na i-replace. Ayan. At i-multiply, dapat na i-multiply, and then i-cancel ang lahat ng i-cancel. Ayan. So, i-multiply dapat na i-multiply by itself. Minultiply natin to. So, ang value niya is 0 din. So, wala na rin yan. And then, dito na tayo mag-focus. So, multiply dapat na i-multiply, and then divide din dapat na i-divide. No? So, ang tamang sagot is 33,124 meter. Bakit po? Eh, bakit nakita natin dito negative values? So, automatically, ang gagawin natin dito is i-multiply natin siya from negative, multiply by negative, magiging positive yung kanyang value. Diba po? Then, the Philippine tarsier is capable of jumping to a height of 1.5 meter in hunting for food. So, we must need to determine the takeoff speed ng tarsier. So, yung given natin, acceleration due to gravity is negative 9.8 meter per second squared, and then yung height natin is 1.5. So, ang required natin is yung initial velocity. Ang equation is Vm squared is equals to Vi squared plus 2ah. So, yung solution niya, i-replace ang mga dapat na i-replace na na given variable sa dito sa given, and then i-multiply yung mga dapat na i-multiply, at ayan, nakikita ninyo. So, syempre, i-apply din naman natin yung proper rule ng PEMDAS, and then ang una natin gagawin is i-multiply natin to negative 9.8 at saka 1.5, and then na-multiply na, na-multiply na natin, and then kung susubukan natin sa calculator, pagkaka-multiply natin, ito, negative 9.8, no? Then multiply natin siya sa 1.5. So, meron na tayong negative 14.7. Then, mamultiply natin siya sa 2. So, meron na tayong 29.4 meter squared second squared. And then, so, nakita natin dito na may negative value siya. Instead of magkaroon tayo na positive value or maging plus yung ano niya dito, yung sign niya dito, or yung fundamental operation na gagamitin natin, naging negative siya, that because of this, negative 9.8. So, meron tayong mga square roots dito na kailangan na hindi natin dapat pampalagpasin, no? So, transpose natin yung mga dapat na i-transpose kasi wala, bali wala na itong 0 meter squared second squared na yan, since 0 naman na yung value niya. So, i-square root natin para ma-cancel out. No? So, ayan. Cancel out natin. And then, hanapan natin ng valid na square root yung 29.4. No? So, according to some kind of value ng 29.4 sa square root niya is, ang magiging outcome niya is 5.42 meter. Yun yung kanyang initial velocity. So, ganun lamang po. So, ano nga bang pinagkaiba ng horizontal motion at vertical motion? So, in terms of forces, acceleration, and then the velocity. So, ayan na po. No? So, in terms of horizontal motion, sa force at saka sa acceleration is absent, and then sa velocity, yung kanyang horizontal motion is constant. Sa vertical motion naman, sa force, no, tsaka sa acceleration is present, no, pero magkaiba sila ng way or yung factor nila, no? So yung present, in terms of the presence of forces of vertical motion, the force of gravity acts downward, and then in terms of presence ng vertical motion sa acceleration, yung g, no, yung acceleration due to gravity is downward at 9.8 meter per second squared. Then sa velocity naman, in terms of vertical motion, it is changing into 9.8 meter per second squared. So, yun lamang po. So, take note that there is a varied type of projectiles depending on how they are launched. Objects thrown vertically upward and objects launched at angles from the horizontal are the other types of projectile. The horizontal distance of the projectile from the starting point where it was launched to where it landed is called the range. It depends on the angle of launch. So, angles of launch affect the range of projectile, and then yung complementary angle niya, angles that when added together equals 90 degrees, make the same range. The longest range is observed at 45 degrees launch, which is yung acute angle. However, this is only true for a single launch speed only. So ano yung mga relationship ng mga ano, 'di ba? Ng mga variables na nakita natin, just like yung angle, height, range, at saka yung time. So yung relationship between angles and the height, as the angle increases, the height also increases. So nakikita natin yung direct proportional relationship na yun. And then yung relationship between the angle and the range, if the angle is less than 45 degrees, the range is increasing. If the angle is greater than 45 degrees, then the range is decreasing. So relationship between the angle and the time, as the angle increases, the time also increases. So sa base sa nakikita ninyo, consider again the cannonball launched by a cannon from the top of a very high cliff. Suppose that the cannonball is launched horizontally with no upward angle whatsoever and with an initial speed of 20 meters per second. If there were no gravity, the cannonball would continue in motion at 20 meters per second in a horizontal direction. Yet, in actuality, gravity causes the cannonball to accelerate downward at a rate of 9.8 meters per second squared. This means that the vertical velocity is changing by 9.8 meters per second if a vector diagram showing the velocity of the cannonball at 1 second interval of time is used to represent how the x and y components of the velocity of the cannonball is changing with time. No, so then x and y velocity vectors could be drawn and their magnitude labeled. The lengths of the vector arrows are representative of the magnitudes of the quantity, such as the diagram shown in this slide. Then the important concept depicted on the above vector diagram is that the horizontal velocity remains constant during the course of the trajectory and the vertical velocity changes by 9.8 meters per second. These same two concepts could be depicted by a table illustrating how the x and y component of the velocity vary with time. So, the numerical information in both the diagram and the table above illustrates identical points. A projectile has a vertical acceleration of 9.8 meters per second downward and no horizontal acceleration. This is to say that the vertical velocity changes by 9.8 meters per second squared, no? That and the horizontal velocity never change. This indeed consistent with the fact that there is a vertical force acting upon a projectile but no horizontal force. A vertical force causes a vertical acceleration. In this case, an acceleration is 9.8 meters per second squared, no? So, but what if the projectile is launched upward at an angle to the horizontal? How would the horizontal and vertical velocity values changes with time? How would the numerical values differ from the previously shown diagram for a horizontal launch projectile? So the diagram below reveals the answer to these questions. The diagram depicts an object launched upward with a velocity of 75.7 meters per second at an angle of 50 degrees above the horizontal dimension. For such an initial velocity, the object would initially be moving at 90.6 meters per second upward and 73.1 meters per second rightward. So, lastly, again, the important concept depicted dito is, inulit lang natin but nakita natin or gusto kong maipakita, no? Inulit ko lang ulit yung presentation by itself, but nakita natin na magkakaiba na yung value niya in terms of base dito, no? Nakita natin na constant yung value ng horizontal velocity, but nakita natin na different yung kanyang value in terms of vertical velocity, that because of this kind of factors. And then dito na lamang po nagtatapos yung ating lesson, no? So hopefully na clear na lahat from this topic. And then next topic, meron magpupuno ulit tayo sa matitinding calculations, and then kailangan lang natin ng matitinding preparation on how to compute the momentum. So saka na yun. And then so kung meron kayong mga questions or clarifications, leave a comment below. And then that's all for today. Goodbye.